hurts. But you got all these bad memories about me.
Rhetoric Williams has the looks of a model, but the star athlete turned to acting to help him find his voice and his purpose.
Better, son, this thing between us.
I'm willing to try. Come on, hang in there, Dad.
Dear God, please let our father make it through this, okay? Please, Lord.
We're gonna get to the hospital, aren't you? Gonna be okay. Don't give up.
What are you doing? Don't stop.
Oh, come on. You have to. This is your job. Save him.
I'm sorry.
No. This is your job. Do your job.
It's too late. I'm sorry.
Welcome, family, to another episode of Lift Every Voice. Bentley here with my new friend, it looks like, Rhetoric Williams, and we are on the set of Young and the Restless, the number one show for 25 years. Rhetoric, how you doing, buddy?
I'm good.
Amazing. Excellent. Did you always have the kind of acting bug somewhere behind you, or did this happen from the modeling? Or
No. I did have the acting bug in high school. I had like an elective because I played sports, football. Mm-hmm. We could take electives, me and a bunch of other guys on the football team. Thought it'd be fun to do the improv and stuff, stand up before the class and be clowns and all that. But it wasn't that. You know, they would give us, you know, these scripts and these like scenes to play out, and we would have to take them home. I dove into that, and I started getting into the characters, and I started just like, you know, letting the imagination take over and just melting away everything and becoming. I just fell in love with the process of getting into a character and just feeling that. When we did our performances, I remember like the whole class was gone. Like I was in a different world. You know, it was like transcendent. It was pretty cool. So that is when it really hit me. I was like, this is something. Like this is. This is my place of peace, you know? It was something where I feel like if you pick a career, it's gotta be something that you're passionate about, yeah, because that's gonna sustain you, you know, through the storm. And it's gonna be a storm, it's gonna be tough. So, you know, that gives you that drive. And for me, it's like, that was the eye of the storm moment where I felt I could do this for a long time. I really like doing this. And that wasn't my life course at the moment. I was playing sports, and logically that made sense. A lot of people were pushing me for football and track and all that, and that's what, you know, got me onto college and all these different things. But that was something that I went back to. It wasn't like, you know, I just, well, let me try this acting thing. I kind of was like, I came to a moment where I did some soul searching, and that's when I kind of looked around. I was like, what are the things that I just really, really like, me, who I really am, resonate to, not all the external stuff.
I want to talk about the soul searching because, you know, I understand, you know, I went to college as an athlete as well. Were you having a moment where you may have been doing well scholastically and even athletically, but you still felt a bit of a void? Is that what you meant, or?
No, that because this wasn't in college when I decided to pursue acting. That's when I went to London. I was like, I went to London and went over there. That's when I was like, what do I really want to do? Because at that point, I was like, I need to figure out, you know, I need to take a snapshot of my life and, you know, map out the trajectory and see what am I doing now? Where am I going to be? What's going on? Because I look at everything with that kind of business, you know, mind frame. So that was the soul searching. So, but I've always had, you know, like that inner, you know, that thing where, you know, there's a high, if you're saying like something to get you through, like knowing a higher power, yeah, that's never been absent. There was never a void or anything like that, I don't feel.
Well said. Let's stop down right here. Rhetoric Williams and I will be right back in just a couple moments. Don't change that dial. Let's get some updates on this character.
All that time, Benny spent in jail. All those years that I wrote him off, why did I do that? Why did I believe those lies? Mom, I don't know who I am anymore. I miss you.
Rhetoric may not have endured the drama of his daytime character, but he can definitely relate.
what would you say to the younger you today?
Oh, what would I personally say to the younger me?
What would you personally say to the younger you, knowing what you know now?
Knowing what I know.
And thinking about that young man.
I would say...